The 2019 Audi A7 is a stone icy fox, plain and straightforward. From its dapper squint to its faceted tail, the new Sportback refreshes the outline-driven subject that began in 2009 with striking, new sheet metal. In any case, while the first A7's enormous hatchback design was a novel bundling exercise matched with a to some degree traded-off backseat involvement, the new model takes various mechanical jumps forward that add some much-needed substance to that style. First of all, the new A7 imparts enough propelled highlights to the tech-loaded A8 to make it among the most advanced vehicles on the planet. However, Audi isn't sharing those fancy odds and ends with the US showcase, more on that later. At the point when the A7 drops in the final quarter of 2018, it will be propelled with a similar trap 3.0 TFSI V6 found in the A8, at any rate until the sportier S8 touches base with the gruntier V8. Creating 340 horsepower and 368 pounds-to-foot of torque, the passage show V6 is a gentle crossover that uses a coordinated starter generator on a 48-volt stage that empowers up to 12 kilowatts of vitality recovery. This powertrain is mated to a 7-speed double-grasp S-tronic gearbox. The alleged belt alternator generator (BAS) is equipped for drifting with the motor off inside certain speed ranges. However, US models won't have the drifting component at dispatch. While we're blasting your air pocket, we ought to presumably additionally say that the A7 won't be offered, at any rate at first, with the A8's gentle boggling prescient suspension framework that sweeps street surfaces ahead and utilizes electromechanical dampers to raise the body and control wheel travel, guaranteeing a satiny ride. Rather, the A7 will accompany a standard steel spring setup at dispatch, and a versatile air suspension will probably be offered as a choice. Slide into the new A7, and its upgraded lodge exhibits a significantly refreshed look and feel over the active model. There are agreeably chiseled inside surfaces with accessible wood facade medicines which delicately bend and stream with those wrinkles. All cunning plan includes whose exclusive conflicting components are the strangely strange, and disappointingly inauthentic, counterfeit back tailpipes that have brought forth all through the Audi lineup. While outside extents stay unaltered, the A7's new aluminum and steel case grows a large portion of an inch in wheelbase and 0.8 crawls in inside length, boosting legroom, headroom, and knee space for raised travelers. Access to those back seats now includes less head slamming, while the smooth, frameless entryway configuration has fortunately been held. Trunk volume develops to 18.9 cubic feet, or 49.1 cubic feet with the back seat, sufficiently down space to put two golf sacks sideways. Likewise with the A8, and much like its sister auto, the Porsche Panamera, physical catches and switches have been everything except destroyed for three glass board shows. Best in Focus is a 10.1-inch infotainment touchscreen inclined towards the driver, one of two new MMI touch reaction screens which summon about each control in this two-ton vehicle. Spare things like the minor volume, control dial, the stalks on the guiding segment, and catches and dials on the controlling wheel. Underneath it is a somewhat littler show for atmosphere control settings. Ordinary checks are likewise dumped for a 12.3-inch virtual cockpit prepared computerized dashboard. While the A7's flat-screen Appaloosa holds a specific interest to extraordinary minimalists, the smooth and flush instrumentation asks the inescapable inquiry, is this overcome new catch-free world extremely something to be thankful for? On an essential level, the new interface is instinctive and intense. Furthermore, hell, in any event Audi left the vac vents as physical controls, dissimilar to the baffling Panamera which requires plunging into a menu to move the vents. In any case, the profundity of Audi's menu framework in some cases makes it troublesome and baffling to get to specific controls that were once basic. The touchscreens likewise do not have the strategic fulfillment of physical catches, also the way that more consideration and accuracy is required while pointing at the tip of your finger at a little territory on a screen in a moving auto. The few key settled catches, like drive mode select, traction control off, maximum defrost, and front light controls are simply spots on a hard, flush surface. Once more, the setup works, yet without an indistinguishable physical consolation from a genuine catch. The rigging selector is a spring-stacked, calfskin-wrapped shifter that offers sensibly fulfilling electromechanical association with the transmission. At any rate, the A7's driving progression are, generally, more physically satisfying than that mimicked mechanical linkage. The standard driving mode creates a smooth, pleasant power conveyance and calm motor activity at bring down rates, feeling more like a Uber luxury car like the S-Class, 7 Series, and yes, A8, than an engaged games vehicle. We're speculating future execution variations, probably S7S and RS7s, will be significantly punchier. Indeed, even with the guiding set to sport, exertion is generally low, however fuel is sufficient, and Michelin Pilot Sport 4 is sufficiently sticky to empower fast cornering. Plunge further into the throttle and the refined murmur of the V6 rises, exchanging some seclusion for incrementally more input. New discretionary acoustic coating goes far toward stifling encompassing commotion in the lodge, and our test auto came furnished with air suspension that additionally figured out how to block out potholes while keeping things fresh and responsive in brandish mode. Launch hush brings forth the dream that the A7 isn't as brisk as it really seems to be. Despite the fact that increasing speed appears to be solid with forceful driving, the absence of clamor covers the way that the V6 is fit for whisking the A7 to 62 miles per hour in just 5.3 seconds, quite quick for a construct motor in light of a major car.